wanted us to be model citizens so no one would ask us about our sins. But there's an intoxicating thrill that comes with entering a home of love and finding skeletons in the closet. And there's something about community that creates competition, and something about competition that leads me feeling uninvited. In the waters of stay in a healthy way and inspire my faith, but the same ones who are ready to jump ship, the second thing turns to thick, and the path I'm on diminishes, or the lights on the sides of the road that I walk down fall dim. And I'm sorry, darling, but you are the worst of them. Shaking knees resound in a profound runaround of emotionally bound conclusions I came to when I felt like I was going to drown. And the bitterness you thought I felt was just your own mind confusing bitterness with acceptance and fixing your broken home with wasting time, cause you thought it would begin. And sometimes I hear the crack on the windowsill, and I miss the days when it had a picture of you and I. And I miss the emotions that came with chasing after this thrill, but mostly I just miss being a part of your life. And I remember when you stopped saying I love you, unless you were just saying I love you too. And then I remember when even that was too hard for you. And I remember the day that the blue suitcase on the top shelf in my closet disappeared, and so did the passion you had for me here, and the fear of knowing you could leave me had vanished. But so did the reason I ever felt purpose, and it hurts to know that you said goodbye, but I just thank God that you're alive, and I'm happy that you're happy, and my joy comes from knowing you were once mine, and I'm grateful for that. And even though there's so many words I wish I could take back, I still thank my God every time I remember you. I still thank my God every time I remember you.